It is 2:30 in the morning. I've just gotten home from the bartending shift. This weekend has been an absolute awful, completely awful. Yesterday I had old men just trying to argue with me left, right and center, just over silly things. Like, couldn't be bothered getting their own tray, so then they wanted me to get their tray for literally no reason than just choosing to be silly. But I suppose that's what happens when there's too much alcohol involved. You see some really ignorant and just purely silly behaviour from human beings. And today, I had even more so. I'll start with the day before yesterday, actually. There was a manager on, a 22-year-old, and he was just riding my back pretty much the whole entire shift. Even to the point where if I was just doing anything at all, like maybe walking along the corridor or just walking from one place to another, nothing, he was just watching me, like being really creepy and weird. And so it got so extreme to the point where I stopped and I stared back at him. A lot of people would be like, oh, I'm staring, I should look away. No, not this guy. He just continues staring away. And I was like, okay, this guy actually isn't all upstairs. There's severely something missing. And later on that night, when the bar was completely closed up after I've closed everything, this other man waltzed in and he asked if the bar's open. I was like, oh no, it's actually all closed for the night. And then this kid overhears and he's like, nah, you're gonna serve him because I'm the boss and this is the boss's call. And I was just like, at that moment, it went through my mind to be like, I don't care who you are or what your position is. You don't treat another human being like that. And I contemplated telling him if it really is something that he feels so deeply, why doesn't he do it himself? But I decided to use patience and gentleness and be kind to the man that had waltzed in, unaware of what was going on. And this manager, I was just like, oh, I've lost all, I don't have any respect for you. No respect for you whatsoever. And when I got home, I was just really like, am I overreacting by, you know? Because this kid, he was literally just riding my back about the fact that there were two more ice cubes needed in a drink, or there was a certain garnish that he would have preferred on a drink. Just like trying to start arguments and just trying to make a big deal out of just the most silliest things ever. And so the Holy Spirit actually confirmed to me, no, this is actually just purely foolish behavior from him. And when I talked to other co-workers, they were like, nah, this guy is definitely, everyone knows that he is missing a few things upstairs. Like, he genuinely is a bit special. And so that just really put me off on the wrong foot as far as this weekend goes. Just to be so emotionally drained from someone just constantly riding your back and making an issue out of every single thing, even down to the fact that you're walking. Like, and then today there was a woman that was stood about a meter back from the bar, deciding on what she wanted to drink, looking up at the drinks menu and all that jazz. And then this other guy comes along and he was sure of what he wanted to order. So then I go and serve this guy, and this woman She got up at me because she wanted me to wait while she decided to make up her mind about what she wanted to order, which is just not in the slightest bit logical, but when alcohol is involved, nobody uses logic, do they? And then she goes, "Do you even like your job?" And I was just like, oh gosh. And I was just like, and I responded, "With anyone who's doing 10-hour shifts, they would naturally start to feel the wear and tear of it." And then she turns around, she's like, "I never asked that. I never effing asked that, did I?" And I was just like, I looked at my coworker and I just like, whoa. And she's like, and then she's like, "What did I ask you? Did I ask you?" And then I was just like, And then I was like, "Nah, you're cut off. You're actually not going to get served." And she was just like, yeah. So, but the thing is, I have encountered that exact same behavior from maybe, I can think of on at least two occasions, from white women that are blonde and they're a bit dollied up. They're not naturally attractive, but because they spend a lot of money on their appearance, you can say that they are good looking because they spend a lot of money and put a lot of effort into their appearance, but you can tell that their natural features aren't actually conventionally attractive. And for some reason, because I guess there's something behind it, I haven't quite articulated it, but I've noticed quite often that when there is someone that spends a lot of money to try and get notoriety for their looks and special treatment for their looks, when they realize that their appearance doesn't get them anything, they just lose the plot and they act very negatively and very entitled, and they will just absolutely just like start screaming and swearing, like they just cannot handle it. And that's what this woman was doing today, and I've encountered other women in the past that have behaved like that as well, and it's very strange. They're obviously got some deep wounds in there, and they're trying to put a lot of emphasis on their appearance to try and overcome and self-soothe those wounds, but cripes, if you treat them like a normal human being, they just really don't respond well. Also, again tonight, as I was serving other customers, there was this guy that kept cutting across me as I was serving other customers, and then he turns around and he's like, "I want the manager." And then he just goes off his head. He's like, "You have attitude problems. Customer service. You need to learn customer service." And I was just like, it was this 5'7" puny white guy. And I was just like, or should I say it, Caucasian? He was just like the old hood in me was like, I could actually just pulverize you into a bloody mess with one hand tied behind my back, and you're really out here acting like this just because you're a customer. Like, there was multiple times over this weekend where I thought, a paycheck isn't enough for this. I don't care, I'm gonna take it into my own hands. I thought that multiple times But then I caught myself going down this track where I was like, huh, yeah, I'm gonna deal with you. I will deal with you. You are mine. And that's when I was like, went into the dish pit and just repented and prayed to God, and I asked for him to forgive me for allowing, for holding on to this bitterness, this resentment and all that kinds of stuff towards these people. And I did feel relieved. And I was just like really reflecting on my life and just really pondering on these last few nights I've been working. And I've just been like, what the hang has my life become? I literally have felt like I'm wandering around out in the middle of nowhere, just my life going nowhere. I'll spend all this time praying and warring in the spirit, but it feels as though I don't have enough time to keep warring against everything that keeps coming against me. There was a brief moment where I was allowed the opportunity to look into why I feel like I'm doing all this work but not having any actual fruit from everything that's going on. And apparently it's because the enemy is stealing from me through some legalities that they have, which I've had another prophet also confirm that that's what's been going on in my life. Actually, I've had multiple people confirm that's what's been going on in my life, that the enemy has been stealing opportunities and finances from me and all that kinds of stuff. And so tonight I was just like, really just reflecting on my life, thinking, why would my husband that God has set aside for me want someone like me? Because I was just like, here I am getting absolutely emotionally and verbally diarrheaed all over, serving drinks, social life almost non-existent, getting shat over by people in the workplace, customers in the workplace, or again, there's this girl at church that set out to make my life hell as well. So even going to church, trying to go to church and go to connect group and stuff, I'm just like, oh, surprise, surprise, there's always someone. I've spoken to other prophets and stuff. Oh, you got to see my armpit. My soul's if it was hairy, but I've spoken to other prophets and stuff, and it just apparently comes with the territory, is that you will get a lot of people that just hate you for no reason, because it's a spiritual thing that will set out to destroy you for no other reason than purely because you exist. And so there's this very demonized girl that every single time I see her, she does all this catchy, stupid stuff. And so eventually one day I vented to a friend about her and I was just like, I am fed up. I can't take it. She's gone too far, because she's gotten to the point where she has tried to, out the blue, through nothing that I've done to her, I have been very controlled in my behavior towards her. I've even complimented her and stuff and been kind to her, but no matter what, you know, it's very much all coming from her. Which reminds me of what Paul said. I can't remember which book he wrote, but he said, if there's any hostility or anything that isn't of love going on in our relationship, it isn't from my end. And so that's very much what's going on in my situation. It's like, it's not me that's doing it, but I am being very, I'm just trying to maintain the fear of God when I interact and when I deal with her, and just living in peace with all. But it's really getting to me as well. I'm like, can I go to church and find peace? No. Can I go to work and feel as though I'm progressing? No. And then when I'm not, it's like, I'm just exhausted. Just so exhausted. And I'm praying and praying and praying and praying and praying. And it seems as though I'm just absolutely swimming for my life, but staying in the same spot. And I'm getting really tired. And I'm asking God to break things away and do stuff. But tonight, as I was walking home from my shift, I was like, no. I have nothing to lose. So what can I do to make my situation better? As in, how can I step up, be stronger, be more of a warrior in God? Because I'm not going to stay down. Yes, it sucks, but I'm going to push on. Things are going to work out. It has been written. Yes, multiple times a day, every day, I get people verbally abuse me. And I have to find peace and hand it to God and maintain the fear of God. But what's the choices that I have? Step away and go and do my own thing and get destroyed by the enemy, which in the past, every time I've stepped away and done my own thing, it's led to complete and utter torture to death, and me trying to commit suicide to try and escape at least the physical pain. But I know that, or there's the other option, where God is abundant, has promised me a place in his kingdom, where God has promised me a mighty ministry, where God has promised me a loving, strong, beyond imagination, amazing husband, where God has promised me many spiritual children, where God has promised me wealth, where God has promised me miraculous gifts, where God has promised me every single thing, and that I am his daughter, and that I am his, and he created me. Specifically for this purpose, and that I will push on. I don't know what I'm gonna be doing, but I'd rather pray and spend time in his presence than do nothing at all. I'll keep drawing closer to him, keep drawing near to him, and push on. That's all I know I can't do. Anyway, I gotta have a shower. I am disgusting. I got the rain and sweat and everything all over me because I had to run through the rain in order to get to work on time because the bus just simply didn't turn up. And when I did get to work, I had people in their 50s and 60s just verbally abusing me, which is quite sad because it's like they're the age of your parents and you'd hope that they would have had some wisdom and or something by that age, but no. They just simply get older, but they're still the same immature and hurtful people that they were all those years ago. Which I can see why God is working on my character, because yes, I may age and get older, but only wisdom and knowledge comes from Him that is necessary. In order to fulfill these things that He has set me aside for. Anyway, bye.